find the bound for the error for the Taylor polynomial. So we know our formula for the error bound. And so here's your example. Say f of x equals cosine x, and P4 is the fourth degree Taylor polynomial for the cosine at x equals pi. So the question is, find the bound for the error between the cosine x and P4 of x on this particular interval. Right, so first, we find the pattern of derivatives, so we can find the fifth derivative of cosine. We might not need a pattern because we can certainly just find the fifth derivative of cosine, but what if the derivatives were real wild and blowing up? We would need some kind of a pattern so we could then just write down the fifth derivative or the seventh or whatever was asked for. We need the fifth because P4 was the fourth Taylor polynomial, and we want to find up to the n plus 1, you see. So we need to go all the way to the fifth derivative. Okay, so fifth derivative cosine, here's your derivatives. We could certainly write down some kind of pattern there, but main thing is that the fifth derivative is negative sine. So on 0 to 2 pi, we already know that sine x is always trapped between negative 1 and 1. So the fifth derivative being negative sine, the absolute value is trapped less than or equal to 1. So that's our error bound. Not the error bound, but the m value of the maximum value of the fifth derivative of f on the interval. So our error bound formula says this, and there's the n plus 1, n plus 1 factorial of the m. The m is your 1. The n plus 1 factorial is 5 factorial. You get the 5 up there. So now we need to know what is the maximum value of x minus pi on that interval. Well, I think you can see that the farthest that x could be away is at 0 or 2 pi. That would make it the largest. So the max value of x minus pi to the fifth power on this interval is 2 pi minus pi, which is pi, and that's the fifth power. So the error between the function and the P4 polynomial, Taylor polynomial degree 4, is this number right here, because the x minus pi to the fourth, fifth, is bounded by pi to the fifth, and the m bound was 1, so this is it, and that comes out to approximately that number. So there's your bound. So when you look at the graph, you see there is a pretty big error between cosine, which is this one, and your P4, which is this polynomial of degree 4, and there's a big error here at pi, at 2 pi. So that's looking good for our estimate, upper bound for that error. And sure enough, in the check, here's P4. You could figure that out or get it from Wolfram Alpha. P4 divided at evaluated at 2 pi is this number, sticking 2 pi in there. And so the error at 2 pi between the function and the Taylor polynomial is 1, because cosine of 2 pi is 1, minus a negative this, which is 1.129. That's the actual error there. Our error bound was 2.551, so this error definitely is less than that number. So 2.551 is reasonable. The actual error turned out less, but that's okay.